Hello and welcome to our series of writing a web server in Rust. For this purpose, we are using one of the most popular and ergonomic Rust framework, Axum. In this video, we will write two APIs for our to-dos app. First, to mark a to-do completed. Second, to delete a to-do. Hence completing, create, read, update, and delete over our to-dos database. Without wasting any further time, let's get started. First, we will create an API to mark a to-do completed. For this, let's create a new function in our IMPL block. This function will access two parameters. First, MySQL pool using Axum state. Next, we need to access ID of a to-do as an identifier. We will access this using path extractor. We are using SQLX crate to access our MySQL database. Let's write SQL statement to mark our to-do status completed. Now we will bind our parameters with SQL statement. And then chain it to execute. This returns a future. So we will await on it. Finally, our variable is of type result. Let's handle this using match statements. Our OK arm will return status OK. And our error arm will return status internal server error. Next, we will continue on to our delete API. For this, we will create a new function in our IMPL block. Let's call it delete a to-do. It will accept two parameters. First, MySQL pool for our database connection using Axum state. And second, we will use a to-do ID as an identifier. So, we will use path extractor to access ID as path parameter. Now, we will write SQL statement to delete a to-do using SQLX. We have made an error in our SQL statement. We will fix this while testing. Now we will bind our parameters with SQL statement. And then chain it to execute. This returns a future. So we will await on it. Finally, our variable is of type result. Let's handle this using match statements. Our OK arm will return status OK. And our error arm will return status internal server error. Let's chain our new routes with other routes. For our API to mark a to-do complete, we will use put HTTP method over endpoint to-do ID mark completed. And for our API to delete a to-do, we will use delete HTTP method over endpoint to-do ID delete. Now let's build and run our project using cargo run. We can see our delete to-do endpoint returns with server error 500. Let's go ahead and fix our SQL for deleting a todo. Now let's build and run our project using cargo run. Everything works perfectly now. In this series, we learned how to use Axum framework and make create, read, update and delete operation over our database using SQL xcrate. If you haven't already, don't forget to like, share and subscribe. Thank you and visit again. Happy coding!